So I've just selected a spot here. Yes, I'm looking for wasps, but that's really only one component.
Got him.
How are we gonna land it?
I don't know. Got no net.
It's the weekend. We've got a beautiful, clear, crisp winter's morning. So we've thrown some rods in the truck, hooked the boat on the back, and we're off on a mission. We're launching my new Stabycraft 1450 off a local beach, and we're off to a favourite old stomping ground that I've not fished for quite a while.
Let's go, Bob.
We've got no bait on board today. It's my choice of spot, and it's Shaw's choice of technique. So, we're soft baiting.
So, we're out in the old back paddock this morning at the Cavelli Islands, and we're gonna be soft baiting, I'd say. Your favourite form of fishing, Shaw?
By far.
So yeah, wash fishing, casting soft baits in and around the rocks. Not something I do a heck of a lot of these days, but it's enjoyable, it's really rewarding. It's a big challenge when you can get one out. So we're just running soft baits, casting them in and around the rocks. We've got miles of rocky coast along here that we can fish. Shaw's fishing 3 to 6 kilo Shadow X rod with Ultegra 3000 spin. I've got my favorite little set here, the Dialuna with the Twin Power 3000. We're gonna flick them around and see how we go. Let's go.
I just got picked up on the drop.
Did you?
Yeah.
So there's not a lot of wash here at the moment, and it's pretty quiet for starters. Not a lot of bites, but Shaw has kicked things off, pulling a nice little fish away from this submerged rock.
First one, back to Tangaroa. Oh, it's only a small one, but that's still, it ate it good though, eh? So that's a good sign, it's starting to come on the chew.
So both of these fish have hit the soft baits hard, which is a good sign. Albeit they're small fish, but it's encouraging because with this style of fishing, it really is just a matter of time until a big boy just comes in and smokes your soft bait.
Oh, yep. Okay, reverse, reverse, just reverse and left hand down. Reverse, left hand down, left hand hard down, yep.
Yeah.
Okay, forward, just straight forward. Motor straight, straight forward.
Okay, for this fish, we're gonna need to maneuver the boat and work the fish away from the rocks. Well, there's actually rocks everywhere underneath us.
I'm gonna cut it off from that rock. Bloody shallow.
But we can at least try and avoid the worst of them and keep the line clear. And that's what makes this sort of soft baiting so good. It's light tackle, big fish, and rugged terrain. It's a real challenge.
How are we gonna land
it? I don't know, we've got no net. Reverse, reverse. I think I've got it. No, I'm not saying anything. Oh, I can see him got colour. We'll take our time, we'll take our time. That's him. I'll just bring it around here. Okay, so we've got no net and I'm not lifting that big boy in. Hey, that was a mean fight. These are the speedster sizes, eh? Bud, let go if you have to, okay? Because that leader will break easy. Yeah, my boy, yeah, that's a minter, bro. It's a nice one, brother.
Wash fish.
They're so good. So rewarding when you get them like that.
Okay, he is
72.
Oh, mate.
Oh, hang on, no, he's not all the way forward. He's 71.
71.
Beauty, beauty. 71 centimeter. And he's going home.
Boom.
Yeah, brother.
Mean. Soft bait brothers.
So now when you take a look at the jig head there, all crunched up, those snapper teeth have crunched it, and that prompts me to check the hook, because I'll do the same for the hook, and you won't be able to see it because it's probably so minute, but the tip of the hook has been rolled over. So I always check that if you get a snag on the rock, if you get a big fish like that, and I carry just one of these little Rapala files. And I use them to touch up my big game fishing hooks, all the way down to little snapper hooks, anything, even flies, saltwater flies. I use, important thing to have in your kit, hook file. We haven't kept any yet, eh? Might keep that bugger. First little fatty that we got. Yeah, dinner, bro. Dinner. Kia ora tangaroa. So we've just selected a spot here just to cast the soft bait into the wash. So just to give you a bit of an idea of what we're looking for, yes, I'm looking for wash, but that's really only one component. I'm looking at how the rock falls away here. We've got wash, but there you go. And shore's been hit. Oh, you dropped them. Okay, so got a nice bite there already. We've got the wash washing up, but we've also got a nice gut, which forms pressure. And you see your smaller bait fish and stuff, they get caught up in that pressure. So it's like a two-pronged thing. For one, the wash provides the predators some cover, so they can get cover under the whitewash. But also, it's forming pressure where they can just sort of sit in an eddy next to the rock and pick up any bait fish that are sort of getting swept up into these gutters. So I'm sort of looking for those ripples of current on the surface and where there might be a little back eddy. And that's where I'm sort of quietly coming up in the boat and we're just lobbing our soft baits, just not right into the wash, but on the edge of it. And where you can see these lines, ripply lines, just like we've got along here. Got them on. Oh, there you go. And there you go, it worked. Oh, that's an all right one, mate.
Oh, nice one, buddy.
Swing around this way, just give a look at it.
Got him.
Oh, mate, right up on the surface. Look at that. These things are coming up to eat the baits, eh? Yeah, nice eater.
Damn monkey.
We've moved around to the front of the islands to find more swell.
Up in the wash.
You don't want huge swells, but when we've got about half a metre, it seems to be bang on, and that's what we've got here. And every likely looking wash edge or gut that we find, we're hooking up. Well, one of us is.
Hey, buddy, who's hooked up again?
Hey, buddy, it's your old dad.
Soft bait master, eh? Maybe I could get a sponsor too, mate. I don't know. You. Did you lead or not, bro? Did it break on the strike? What sort of knot did you tie?
Oh, yes.
You just reverse straight back. We're just a little bit gun-shy because Shaw just got smoked and run to ground. And this is a gut where I catch a lot of big snapper.
Oh, look at that, boy. Yo.
Yeah. Eater. Eater, it's about as big as I'd go. Chomp, chomp.
It's coming home. Got a tongue on.
Don't be a dick, mate. It's disrespectful. There you go. Nice fish. Don't snap your rod, mate.
Penny.
Hey, nice, bro.
It's all go. Snappers, cameras, boats. And speaking of boats, how good is this Staby 1450 side console for this sort of work?
As soon as we find some wash, find some fish, eh? Nice. What do you reckon, bae? Get a good hookup rate, eh? On these?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
got a shot then.
Wait, wow, got another shot. Why are you giving me the stink eye, boy? Don't be like that. Oh, shit. It's gone over to that bommy.
Ah, oh, sweet.
Oh yeah. Oh, it is. Look, go forward. Yeah, go forward because I can see the bottom there. Oh man, that rod is beautiful.
Nice
Yeah, you can cut one.
You turn the key off and carry on casting in front of us. I got this fish. Man, there's some fish up in here. Yeah, no, you carry on fishing. You carry on fishing, mate.
Yeah. Size, it's
not that big, it's not that big, but scrapped hard though, bro. Scrapped hard as. But still, he can go home. Oh, yeah. Kibble. That is.
Rod's so mint, hey?
Yeah, felt good fighting the fish, and just it's, like, I took a lot of the load out, even though I had a hard drag.
Of course, we don't want to get snagged in the weeds, so we're just running a relatively light jig head, 3/8 of an ounce, with a 7-inch tail, so it's going to be quite a slow sink. So we're just sort of trying to bring it out beyond the edge of the wash. We're also looking for clean water as well, because it's a very visual thing. The snapper aren't swimming along and they smell it. They're seeing it. They're seeing it fall down, and they're coming out from where they're sitting in that little eddy on the edge of the wash, on the edge of that current that I explained, and it's they're coming out and grabbing it. So that just gives you a little bit of an idea of what we're looking for and how we fish it. You don't actually have to be hard on the bottom like you might think. In fact, we've had them come and eat their soft baits right off the surface doing this. Oh, picked up on the drop. Got him. Holy smoke, look at that. It's an eaten one, bro. So we've been letting our kahawai go, and I do love to take at least one kahawai every time, just because it's so good to eat fresh. This one swallowed that soft bait right down deep, so this one we're not going to let go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bleed it and I'm going to put it in the live bait tank here, flush the blood out before I put it on ice. Man, that has actually swallowed it. Okay, give it a nick across the gills, pump that blood out. So this bait is having in the live bait tank there, some nice cold winter water on it, keeps the blood off of our ice. Just leave it there for 5 minutes, let it clean out, and then chuck it in there with the snapper. Well, the wash fishing's been pretty successful, but this spot here, we're just taking a little bit of a different theory. Instead of the wash being what's pushing the food up, we've got a bit of a channel where there's a lot of current. And so instead of using what my eyes can see in terms of the wash and the ripple effect on the surface, I'm using my Freno sounder. And you can see here, oh, hang on a sec, sorry. Back with you in a sec. There we go, that's better. So yeah, now we can show you what we're doing. So what we've got here is we've got the tide running right through between these two islands here, so there's a lot of current coming through, and we've got this long reef creating a barrier. So I know the current's going to be hitting that and pushing up to the surface, so there should be fish feeding across here. So sort of use my sounder, and then if we look on the sounder side, here we go, we've got some marks starting now already, just up off the bottom. It's going to be snapper. Shore's flicking away up there, and we're just going to try something a little bit different. Still using the same soft baits, and there's still going to be food here. It's just going to be generated by a different process, current as opposed to the surging of the swells.
Must be food pushing up there,
blue mau mau on the surface. Blue mau mau on the surface, there you go. Shore just said that there's some blue mau mau pushing up on the surface, so there you go. While I've used the sounder, the eyes will also tell us how the current is reacting and where the food is. I'm not sure if you better make them out on the camera here. Could be snapper there now, not because there's so much that they're going to be eating the mau mau, but the same current that's bringing that food up to the mau mau is bringing food up for the snapper that'll be sitting down a little bit lower. And right where I said too. Are you get hit too, Shaw? Yeah, get him, boy. You got him. Here, good boy. There you go, double hook up. And we are right where I said, just running up onto that reef. You can see the current here, actually. If you look carefully, we've got another visual cue. We've got the current starting to swirl as the pressure is being formed there. I don't know if you can make it out on the surface, the current swirling there, but that's what's forcing the food up. Hey, see, just like your old dad, eh? Oh, nice fish, bud. Yeah, this one's alright. Here we go, we're about to see. See, wash fishing worked, and so did the old use your sounder, use your smarts. That is a nice fish. Yeah. Nice.
Oh, fatty.
Yeah, you keep your fatty and I'll let this one go. It's probably a bit big.
Sweet.
Nice, bro. Okay, it's going home. Boom. Oh, good one. Take your time out in the sand, mate. Enjoy it. Enjoy yourself. Oh, I've just been eating. Oh, I was mucking around with that camera. There was something holding onto my soft bait. Oh, nice.
Nice fish.
Oh yeah, beauty, well done. It's 25 pound leader, eh? Nice one, buddy. Beautiful colours on them.
Wanna get a photo?
Come on, grab them there. Ew! So there we go again, another one exactly the same scenario. Just coming up where that current is. Just been hitting those fish. Right where that current's pushing us.
Just flicking it, you know.
Flicking it just above the bottom. I mean, look at this.
One nice fish after the other.
Well, just like I don't know how many we've caught. Only been out for a couple of hours and got a decent feed in the bin. Caught a couple of nice ones and we've shed a little bit of knowledge about just how to go and do it yourself. And that's all we've got time for now. You can see all of the knots and rigs, everything, how we rig all of this up, and more videos at ultimatefishing.tv. And we'll see you again soon.